Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to do a coffee special thing in the Ninja Creami. Nice easy recipe, let's get to it. There's a new coffee van opened up in my small town. I normally go for coffee to Cochran Coffee Traders. It's a great store, love the coffee, love the people. It's really good quality, but I thought I'd try this new place that opened. It's a van, so, you know, they kind of travel around the town. It's a great idea. And when we were there, they were just down the bottom of the road, so we thought we'd have a little meander down to the car park, or the parking lot, as it may well be known, and see what was what. So we grabbed a couple of drinks, and in the front they had some other things that I wanted to try. This is Arequipa. I probably murdered that, so apologies if I have. So I grabbed this. It's 150 grams of this. And they also had these, which... cafecitas. They're little coffee biscuits. Cookies, as they say over here. So I thought we'd use these and make a super simple coffee, cookies and cream, ice cream in the Ninja Creami. Because there's not a lot of this, we're going to make just one single tub of it, and this is what you are going to need. 150 grams of arequipe with coffee, one small pack, which is 35 grams of cafecita coffee cookies. You are going to need 167 grams of 2% milk, 205 grams of 33% whipping cream, 39 grams of dextrose, 0.8 grams of salt, and then we're good to go. Why are we using dextrose in this and not sugar? Well, there's loads of sugar in this. This is, I think, 45% or 40% sugar. So there's a lot of sugar in that. And to try and balance a really small portion such as this is difficult. If you were to make a double batch, so 1 liter, or a even to a degree, a Ninja Creami Deluxe with 750 mil portion, it's easier. It's much easier once you start balancing recipes at 1 liter or 1 kilo. But we are limited by how much we can use here. So if I were to use sugar, straight table sugar, I can't get the balance right. I can't get the freezing point right because there's then too much sugar. Too many solids, too much sugar, but it doesn't bring the freezing point up. So the way to do that is to start dealing with what's the most important part. Now for me, the freezing point is the most important part, not the amount of sugar in something. Now, generally they go hand in hand, but that is not always the case, because if you add too much sugar, yes, you will start to increase the freezing point, but that's only relative to the sugar. Once you start adding all the other ingredients like skim milk powder, cream, you know, if you're using different sugars, dextrose, erythritol, xylitol, allulose, so many different things, they all start to change that freezing point. So when you look at a recipe, it's about the amount of fat. Doesn't really make any difference. Anywhere from kind of 5% up to glorious 22% UK fatty ice cream. You can do anything in that range, that's fine. Sugar content, it's kind of subjective, because some people like sugar content down into like the 12% range. That's really low, and you start to lack solids in ice cream and the freezing point ends up too low. Gelato has much higher amounts of sugar because it's much lower in fat than standard American ice cream. So gelato can have kind of right away up to 22% sugar, but it balances out right. You don't think it's super sweet because of how the recipe is. Milk solids, non-fat, you can go down to 5%, which is where we are in this. This will be a good chunk of milk solids, non-fat. Milk solids, non-fat, it just means that we want the milk proteins to make luxury ice cream. It's super important to create a smooth mouthfeel and texture. If we don't have milk solids or milk proteins, then we're looking at plant-based recipes. And that actually is the hardest part of a plant-based recipe, is to get that mouthfeel by adding something in equivalency to milk protein. And this is where inulin comes in generally, but you can use like maltodextrin as well. But, well, that's a thing for a different video. Finally, we're looking at total solids. This is kind of where we start to balance out recipes with sugar. We want to be somewhere around late 30s, early 40s. You can go up to mid 40s percent, that is. And then water content, you know, somewhere between the late 40s to early 60s percent water content. So in this tub, which I think is 550 grams by the time it comes up to that line, we've got 61% water. We have 38% solids. We have 5% milk solids non-fat. We have 18% sugar, but this is dextrose. So this is dextrose combined with the sugar in here, combined with the sugar, lactose in our milk and cream. And we have 13.3% fat. So fat content is great. Sugar content is fine because we're using dextrose, which is nowhere near as sweet as standard table sugar, but it really hits that freezing point nicely. I like to use cold process stabilizers for Ninja Creami. It's just easy, but we need to get this mixed up. So we're gonna get a bowl and get all our ingredients in there. Nice clean bowl, get rid of that. Here we go. First thing we're gonna weigh. Weigh your stuff. Right, 205 grams of whipping cream. 204. Don't make me open another one. 205. I mean, you couldn't make that up. 205 grams of our whipping cream. It wouldn't make any difference. 203, 202. Don't worry about it. 167 grams. Of stupid to pour milk. If you don't have dextrose, can you use sugar? At a pinch, yes, you could use sugar. The one absolute saving grace of the Ninja Creami is it can decimate things down to, you know, whatever. But with a serving temperature of minus 13, it will go hard again if you put it back in the freezer. Hard. So you'll have to spin it again. If you use dextrose, it won't go hard, super hard, when you put it back in the freezer. You can just take it out and eat it. Which is how I make all my ice creams. Dextrose, 39 grams. We're gonna use pink Himalayan salt just because we can. This is 0.8 grams. I don't know, not weighing it out. Something like that. And then really all we need to do is add this. So stabilizer, yeah, I'm gonna use guar gum. I mean, in the pistachio, I mean, super dark color. That's 100% the, right, first things first. Definitely part of the dulce de leche family, which is never a bad thing. I did an incredible dulce de leche recipe months ago now from a friend that lives down in Mexico, originally from Argentina. Anyway, we're gonna put all of that in there. We need all of this, so don't leave any on the spoon, don't leave any in the tub. Let's get that all in here because I really want to lick that spoon. Right, pops in the microwave. We're gonna pop this in the microwave just to warm it up a little bit. We don't wanna go too mad, so something like 30 seconds. That's 30 seconds. We're not super heating this, but we wanna heat it enough so that that arequipe, again, apologies, blends into our dairy. Needs just a little bit more heat. So that heat, again, is just to get that arequipe dissolved into our liquid. It's there now, it's dissolved. You might find a couple of tiny little bits blended back in. Doesn't matter. Finally, we are just gonna add our guar gum. So I'm gonna take 1 teaspoon of sugar, 1/8 teaspoon of guar gum, mix it up. That is the purpose of the sugar. Make sure there's no lumps in your powder. Add that in there. 1 teaspoon of sugar will make no difference to the recipe whatsoever. Right, that in there. Let's get it in our Ninja Creami tub. Perfect. Lid on. In the freezer it goes. It's actually been like, I don't know, a week since I've prepared this. Let's get it in. see how it's getting on. Don't think it needs any more. Let's get this out. All right, so the first thing to note is these little coffee biscuits, probably cafejita. I'm terrible at pronunciation. They smell quite nice. They smell like coffee cake. Old fashioned coffee and walnut cake. They're nice. They'd work for a cookies and cream in this. So it says product of Colombia on the back. It would make sense as a Colombian coffee company. Let's try a proper sized portion of the ice cream. Super smooth, you know, exactly what you'd expect from the channel. Flavor, it's a hybrid flavor between, you know, dulce de leche and coffee. It's a nice coffee flavor. It is a nice coffee flavor. It's a really unique kind of combination. I've never had this like caramel coffee combo before. And I like it. Yeah, really tasty. For coffee ice cream, it's not got a strong enough flavor. For caramel ice cream, it's not got enough flavor. For coffee caramel ice cream, it works. Because you don't want either one to overpower. But you could probably make this with standard dulce de leche and some instant coffee powder. If you wanted to adjust, then you can heat up your ingredients and steep coffee beans, you know, that kind of thing in there. That will give you a very similar flavor as well. Delicious, really nice. And I'm really glad that we popped down the road and bought some coffee to get these. I mean, we didn't buy the coffee to get these ingredients, but they were there staring at me in the face and I thought, I'm gonna make some ice cream out of that. So, a nice new product to try and make ice cream and or gelato out of, depending on what recipe you use. Thanks very much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you next time.